If you ever need to hide the content of a view when the user takes a screenshot, you'll soon realize that iOS doesn't offer an official way to implement this behavior. There's a notification called User Did Take Screenshot that you can listen to, but as its name suggests, it will be fired after the screenshot has been taken. So this notification will be fired too late for you to hide the content of a view. However, there's still a way to hide the content of a view during a screenshot. Keep in mind that it's not an official method, so it's not guaranteed to keep working in future versions of iOS. For this, we're going to use a built-in UIKit view that actually implements the behavior of hiding its content during a screenshot. It's a component that we are all familiar with, UI text field. But a UI text field with the property is secure text entry set to true. Because such a text field is meant to input sensitive information like a password, it automatically hides its content when a screenshot is taken. So how can we take advantage of this behavior in order to apply it to an arbitrary view? As it turns out, it's actually quite simple. First, we set the property isUserInteraction_enabled to false so that the user can't mistakenly interact with the text field. Then we get the subview that actually implements the hiding behavior and we disconnect it from its subviews and superview. As you can notice, this code feels quite hacky and it's a good reminder that this trick is not guaranteed to keep working in future iOS versions. And finally, we simply add the view that we want to hide in screenshots as a subview. So let's give it a try. I'm going to wrap the code into a UI view representable so that we can easily use it in SwiftUI. There's quite a bit of code, but it's really nothing more than the standard boilerplate to make a UIKit view usable in SwiftUI. And now, all I need to do is to apply the modifier to a view, launch the simulator, and take a screenshot. As you can see, the view on which I attach the modifier doesn't appear in the screenshot. And if you were wondering, yes, the view will also be hidden in screen recordings. Now, before we end, one word of warning. If you end up using this code and you want to test it in the simulator, make sure to take the screenshot like I did using the menu command device, then trigger screenshot. Because if instead you use the button above the simulator or the shortcut command S, you'll notice that the view is still present in the screenshot. That's actually normal and that's because the simulator is taking the screenshot by simply saving the content of the screen of the emulated iPhone to an image file, completely bypassing iOS internal mechanism to take a screenshot. So basically, this is just like if you were to take a photo of the screen of your iPhone, it's normal that the modifier doesn't have an effect in this situation. Before we end, I have a big thank you for my colleague Ali, who's written code examples for this trick that I've used to prepare this video. You have the link to his GitHub repo in the description. That's all for this video. If you've enjoyed it, don't forget to leave a like and subscribe to my channel so that you don't miss the next ones. Thank you for watching and see you next time.